Top 10 Religions in the World. Religion is a social cultural system of designated behaviors and practices, morals, worldviews, texts, sanctified places, prophecies, ethics, or organizations that relates humanity to supernatural, transcendental, or spiritual elements. We have shortlisted top 10 religions in terms of number of followers of that religion. Let's have a look at them. Please like our video and share it with your friends. Do not forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. On number 10, we have Judaism. Judaism is strictly monotheistic religion practiced by the Jewish people, an ethnic and religious nation descended from the historic peoples of Israel and Judah. Jewish people worship in holy places known as synagogues, and their spiritual leaders are called rabbis. The six-pointed star of David is the symbol of Judaism. Jewish people believe there is only one God who has established a covenant or special agreement with them. Their God communicates to believers through prophets and rewards good deeds while also punishing evil. Most Jews believe that their Messiah hasn't yet come, but will one day. Today, there are about 14.5 to 17.4 million Jews worldwide. Most of them live in the United States and Israel. Traditionally, a person is considered Jewish if his or her mother is Jewish. On number 9, Spiritism. Spiritism is a philosophical doctrine established in France in the mid-19th century. Allan Kardec refers to the Spiritism as a science dedicated to the relationship between spirits and human beings. Specific aspects of the doctrine of Spiritism includes plurality of worlds, nature of the soul, the incarnated spirit, and the disincarnation of a person. On number 8, Sikhism. Sikhism is a young religion founded in the early 1500s CE in Punjab, northern India, by the Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak was raised as a Hindu in the Muslim-ruled Mughal Empire, but he rejected both dominant faiths and began preaching his own religion. A community formed around him. Over the next two centuries, the Sikhs would be led by 9 more gurus. The last living guru named the Sikh holy book Guru Granth Sahib as his successor, and there has since been no single leader of the Sikh community. Despite being a religious minority, the Sikhs overthrew the Mughals and founded a major empire in northern India in the 1800s. Followers of this religion are 28 million people. On number 7. African traditional and diasporic. This religion is a mixture of traditional Yoruba, Fon, and Bantu beliefs which originated from different regions in Africa. It has also incorporated some aspects of the Catholic faith over time. One of many examples of an African diasporic religion is Candomblé. The name Candomblé means dance in honor of the gods. Practitioners of Candomblé believe in one all-powerful god called Oludumare, who is served by lesser deities. These deities are called Orixas. Candomblé practitioners believe that every person has their own individual Orixa, which controls his or her destiny and acts as a protector. Music and dance are important part of Candomblé ceremonies. Followers of this religion are almost 100 million people. On number 6, Buddhism. Buddhism is a religious tradition founded by Gautama Buddha in the early 1400s BCE. Buddhists engaged Hindus and Jains in religious dialogues for centuries, developing mutual competing traditions and beliefs. Buddhism flourished in India, receiving support from several powerful leaders before declining during the medieval period. The three basic tenets of Buddhist teachings are: number one, nothing is fixed or permanent. Number two, actions have consequences. That is called karma. Number three, change is possible. Buddhism continued to grow and develop in East Asia, having a profound impact on the cultural landscape of the entire region. On number five, Chinese traditional religion. Chinese traditional religion is especially difficult to define, since it's a catch-all phrase for an unofficial mixture. The traditional religion of the Chinese people is often described as a blend of Taoism, Buddhism, and Confucianism. However, there is really a fourth element or tradition, which some label classical, that is folk religion. Chinese folk religion is a faith whose theology, rituals, and officiants are widely diffused into other secular and social institutions. Chinese folk religion is not organized, nor it is equipped with theologies. Chinese folk religion has no fixed scripture. Partly for this reason, the communist government regarded folk religion as feudal superstition, unworthy of recognition. Number of followers are 680 million people. On number 4, Hinduism. Hinduism is the major religion of India, practiced by more than 80% of the population. In contrast to other religions, it has no founder. No single creed or doctrine binds Hindus together. Intellectually, there is complete freedom of belief, and one can be monotheist, polytheist, or atheist. Hinduism is a syncretic religion welcoming and incorporating a variety of outside influences. The most ancient sacred texts of the Hindu religion are written in Sanskrit and called the Vedas. Veda means knowledge. There are four Vedic books, of which the Rig Veda is the oldest. It discusses multiple gods, the universe, and creation. On number 3, non-religious people. Secular means not connected with religious or spiritual matters. As secularism grows, atheists and agnostics are trying to expand and diversify their rank. Though atheists and agnostics are words that are often used together or cited in similar contexts, they do not mean the same thing. Agnostic is a Greek word which means unknown. It means a person who does not believe or is unsure of something. On the other hand, atheist is a Greek word which means not. In English, it simply means a person who believes that God does not exist. On number 2, Islam. Islam is a strictly monotheistic faith founded by the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the year 607 in present-day Saudi Arabia. The five pillars of Islam are the core beliefs and practices of Islam. Number 1, profession of faith, Shahada. The belief that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last messenger of Allah. Number 2, prayer, Salat. Muslims pray facing Mecca 5 times a day, at dawn, noon, mid-afternoon, sunset, and after dark. Number 3, Zakat. Muslims donate a fixed portion of their income to community members in need. Number 4, fasting, Ramadan. Healthy adult Muslims fast in Ramadan from dawn until dusk. Number 5, pilgrimage, Hajj. Every Muslim whose health and finances permit it must make at least one visit to the holy city of Mecca. Sources of Islamic faith are the Quran, that is word of God, and tradition, Hadith, that is saying and deeds of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Islam means surrender to the will of Allah, the all-powerful who determines humanity's fate. Presently, there are 2 billion followers of Islam worldwide. On top 1, Christianity. Christianity is a monotheistic religion centered around the personage of Jesus Christ. The New Testament Gospels describe Jesus as a teacher and miracle worker. Jesus set the requirements for participation in the kingdom of God as a change of heart and repentance from sins, love of God and neighbor, and concern for justice. In 30 AD, he was executed on a cross in Jerusalem, a brutal form of punishment for those considered a political threat to the Roman Empire. After his death, his followers came to believe in him as the Christ, the Messiah. The Gospels report his resurrection and how the risen Jesus was witnessed by many of his followers. The Apostle Paul helped spread the new faith in his missionary travels. The church became favored under his successors, and in 380, the Christianity was proclaimed the state religion. Through its missionary activity, Christianity has spread to most parts of the globe. Presently, there are 2.4 billion followers of this religion. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below.
Top 10 Intercontinental Ballistic Missiles in the World. Hello friends, welcome to Just Top 10. The intercontinental ballistic missiles are designed for delivering nuclear weapons. A single missile can carry several warheads, each of which will strike a different target. All of the intercontinental ballistic missiles mentioned here in this video are extremely devastating and can wipe out entire countries. Watch the full video to see currently top 10 intercontinental ballistic missiles in the world. Let's start our video. On number 10, let's start with Bulava missile. The Bulava is a new Russian submarine launched intercontinental ballistic missile. It is carried by the new Russian Bore-class submarines. This ballistic missile was first deployed and declared operational in 2013. It has a declared range of 9,500 kilometers. This missile can carry 6 MIRVs with a yield of 150 kiloton each. It can also carry 10 MIRVs, though to a range of only 4,000 kilometers. The Bulava has an astro-inertial guidance with Russian GLONASS satellite navigation system update. On paper, the Bulava is more capable than some of the missiles on this top 10 list. However, it still has teething problems that need to be fixed. On number 9 we have JL-2 missile. The JL-2 is a new Chinese submarine launched ballistic missile. It is a naval variant of the land-based DF-31. It was first deployed in 2015. It is carried by Jin-class submarines. For the first time, China has a credible sea-based nuclear strike capability. It is estimated that the new JL-2 missile has a range of 7,400 to 8,000 kilometers. Such range is sufficient to reach all areas of Europe, India, Russia, and most areas of the United States. It carries a single 250 to 1000 kiloton warhead, or up to 3 to 4 MIRVs with 90 kiloton each. On number 8, we have DF-31AG missile. The DF-31AG is a new Chinese intercontinental ballistic missile. First images of this missile system appeared in 2013. It was reportedly tested in 2015 and was first publicly revealed in 2017. A total number of 16 DF-31AG launchers with missiles were publicly presented during this parade. The DF-31AG is a solid fuel missile. It has three stages. This missile has a range of 11,200 kilometers and can reach all areas of United States, Europe, and Russia. It carries 3 to 5 MIRVs. On number 7, we have DF-41 missile. The DF-41 is currently the most powerful intercontinental ballistic missile developed in China. It is one of the deadliest intercontinental ballistic missile in the world. It is based on an 8-axle launcher vehicle and is similar in concept to Russian road mobile intercontinental ballistic missiles such as Tupolev and Yars. First test launch of this missile was made in 2013, and the second followed in 2014. The DF-41 is a solid fuel missile. It has an estimated range of 12,000 km and carries up to 10 multiple independently targetable re-entry vehicles, MIRVs. Its range is sufficient to reach all areas of United States, Europe, and Russia. On number 6, the M51 missile. The M51 is a French submarine-launched ballistic missile. Design work on this missile started in 1992 and it was first deployed in 2010. The M51 has a range of 10,000 km with reduced payload, and 8,000 km with full payload. Such range is sufficient to strike most areas in China, Russia, or the United States, firing straight from the pier. Each missile carries 6 to 10 independently targetable warheads. Each has a blast yield of 107 kiloton. Furthermore, this missile carries penetration aids in order to overcome hostile air defenses. On number 5, R-29 RMU 2.1 Laner missile. The R-29 RMU 2.1 Laner is a recent Russian submarine-launched ballistic missile. It is an improved version of the previous R-29 RMU 2 Sinova. This missile was adopted in 2014. It is used on Delta IV class submarines. This Russian submarine launched missile has a maximum range of 8,300 km with full load and 12,000 km with reduced load. Each missile can carry 12 low yield warheads. Most likely that these have 100 to 300 kiloton capacity. On number 4, LGM-30G Minuteman III. The Minuteman III is the most numerous US ballistic missile. There are 450 of these missiles in the US service. Another 50 to 75 missiles are in reserve. That's the biggest number of ballistic missiles in the world. These are managed by the United States Air Force Global Strike Command. There are silos to fire the Minuteman III missile all around the United States, like in Montana, North Dakota, Wyoming, and other US Air Force bases. The Minuteman III missile has a maximum range of 13,000 km. The Minuteman III carries a payload of 3 independently targetable re-entry vehicles. Each one of these MIRVs is armed with nuclear warhead with a destructive power between 300 to 500 kiloton. It also carries penetration aids to counter enemy missile defense systems. On number 3, we have RS-24 Yars. The Russian RS-24 Yars is a new intercontinental ballistic missile. It is known in the West as SS-29. It is an improved version of the previous RS-12M Tupolev. It was developed both as a road mobile and silo-based system that would use the same missile. It was adopted by Russian strategic missile forces in 2010 and deployed during the same year. This solid fuel missile is similar to that of the Tupolev. The Yars has a range of 12,000 km. The main difference from the previous missile is that Yars is MIRV equipped and can carry at least 6 independently targetable warheads with 100 to 300 kiloton yield. On number 2nd, R-36M2 Voyevoda missile. The Soviet R-36, Western designation SS-9 SCARP, was first tested in 1971. Eventually it evolved into an R-36M family, known in the West as SS-18 Satan. A first batch of 56 missiles was deployed in 1977. These were later replaced by more modern variants. The latest one is the R-36M2 Voyevoda, SS-18 Mod 6. It was first deployed in 1988. The SS-18 Satan is a very capable missile, mainly because of its high speed and extremely high throw weight. Russia was and is still ahead of the West in development of missile engines. The R-36M2 missile has a range of 11,000 km and carry up to 10 MIRVs with a blast yield of 0.75 to 1 megaton and up to 40 penetration aids. So its nuclear warheads are hard to intercept by air defense. On top one, we have Trident II missile. The Trident E-5, or Trident II, is a submarine-launched ballistic missile. It is an improved version of the previous Trident C-4 with greater payload, range and accuracy. It was first deployed in 1990. The Trident II missile has a range of 7,800 km with full load and 12,000 km with reduced load. So even though the Trident II does not have the longest range comparing with other ICBMs, ballistic submarines armed with these missiles can always approach their targets, to reduce their flight range, so to speak. Each US Trident II missiles can carry up to 14 warheads with a 475 kiloton yield each.
Thank you guys, for watching this video.
We hope you liked this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below in comment box.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel, and press the bell icon.
Take care of yourselves, friends and family members. Bye for now.
Adios amigos.
Top 10 inventions of the history. Though we have been on the planet for a relatively short amount of time, modern Homo sapiens have dreamed up and created some amazing, sometimes far out things. From the moment someone bashed a rock on the ground to make the first sharp-edged tool, to the debut of the wheel, to the development of BMW and the internet, several key advancements stand out as particularly revolutionary. Here are our top picks for the most important inventions of all the time. Please like our video and share it with your friends. Do not forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. On number 10, we have the wheel. No list of top inventions can be completed without the wheel and axle. Before the wheel showed up around 3500 BC, invented by ancient Greeks, we were very limited in how much and how far we could travel with products. After invention of wheel, now transportation is a piece of cake for everyone. On number 9, we have the nail. Without nails, civilization would surely crumble. This key invention dates back more than 2000 years to the ancient Roman period and became possible only after humans developed the ability to cast and shape metal. Previously, before invention of nails, wood structures had to be built by interlocking adjacent boards geometrically. On number 8, the compass. Ancient mariners navigated by the stars, but that method didn't work during the day or on cloudy nights. The Chinese invented the first compass between 9th and 11th century. Soon after, the technology passed to Europeans and Arabs through nautical contact. The compass enabled mariners to navigate safely far from land, increasing sea trade and contributing to the age of discovery. On number 7, the printing press. The German Johannes Gutenberg invented the printing press around 1440. Though others before him, including inventors in China and Korea, had developed movable type made from metal, Gutenberg was the first to create a mechanized process that transferred the ink, which he made from linseed oil and soot, from the movable type to paper. With this movable type process, printing presses exponentially increased the speed with which book copies could be made, and thus they led to the rapid and widespread dissemination of knowledge for the first time in the history. According to record, 20 million volumes had been printed in Western Europe by 15th century. Now on number 6, the internal combustion engine. Combustion engines convert chemical energy into mechanical work. Decades of engineering by many scientists went into designing the internal combustion engine, which took its essentially modern form in the latter half of the 19th century. The engine ushered in the industrial age as well as enabling the invention of a huge variety of machines, including modern cars and aircraft. In a four-stroke internal combustion engine, the first one is intake stroke. In this stroke, air and vaporized fuel are drawn in. In compression stroke, fuel vapor and air are compressed and ignited. Then in combustion stroke, fuel combusts and piston is pushed downwards, powering the machine. And finally, in exhaust stroke, exhaust is driven out. This was a tough one. As the steam engine is pretty great too, we decided on the combustion engine primarily because it's small. Not to mention, you don't need some guy shoveling coal into a furnace to make the magic happen. Without this, we are still stuck on the train to get everywhere. The automobile doesn't exist, and I am still cutting my grass with scissors. On number 5, the telephone. Though several inventors did pioneering work on electronic voice transmission, Alexander Graham Bell was the first to be awarded a patent for the electric telephone in 1876. He drew his inspiration from teaching the deaf and also visits to his hearing impaired mom. He called the first telephone an electrical speech machine. The invention of telephone quickly took off and revolutionized global business and communication. When Graham Bell died on August 2, 1922, US telephone service stopped for a minute to honor him. On number 4, the light bulb. According to historians, 24 people were instrumental in inventing incandescent lamps throughout the 1800s. Thomas Edison is credited as the primary inventor because he created a completely functional lighting system, including a generator and wiring as well as a carbon filament bulb in 1879. We have a bit of a love or hate relationship with the light bulb. Before it was around, productivity was limited to the daylight hours. So when the sun went down, everyone went to bed, and then got up to start working when the sun showed up again. The light bulb made it possible to work all day and night, significantly increasing productivity. Unfortunate for us, now also night shift exists in our jobs. Stupid light bulb. That's all because of you. On top 3, we have penicillin. It is one of the most famous discovery stories in history. In 1928, the Scottish scientist Alexander Fleming noticed a bacteria-filled petri dish in his laboratory with its lid accidentally ajar. The sample had become contaminated with a mold, and everywhere the mold was, the bacteria was dead. That antibiotic mold turned out to be the fungus penicillium, and over the next 2 decades, chemists purified it and developed the drug penicillin, which fights a huge number of bacterial infections in humans without harming the humans themselves. On top 2nd, we have computer. The computer was born not for entertainment or email, but out of a need to solve a serious number crunching crisis. Before Charles Babbage came along, a computer was a person, someone who literally sat around all day adding and subtracting numbers and entering the results into tables. In 1819, Charles Babbage visited the City of Light and viewed the unpublished manuscript with page after page of tables. If only, he wondered, there was a way to produce such tables faster with less manpower and fewer mistakes. He thought of the many marvels generated by the Industrial Revolution. If creative and hardworking inventors could develop the cotton gin and the steam locomotive, then why not a machine to make calculations? He spent 8 years perfecting his idea. In 1832, he produced a functioning prototype of his table-making machine that is called computer. On top one, the internet. It really needs no introduction. The global system of interconnected computer networks known as the internet is used by billions of people worldwide. Countless people helped developing it, but the person most often credited with its invention is the computer scientist Lawrence Roberts. In the 1960s, a team of computer scientists working for the US Defense Department, that is ARPA, Advanced Research Projects Agency, built a communications network to connect the computers in the agency called ARPANET. It used a method of data transmission called packet switching, which Roberts, a member of the team, developed based on prior work of the other computer scientists. ARPANET was the predecessor of the internet. Lawrence Roberts is given the most credit for this amazing invention that has changed the way we live, design, are entertained, communicate, learn, and more. Thanks to the internet, we can find information on just about any topic in seconds, while revolutionizing the way people do business. And the best thing about the internet, unlike inventions like the wheel, the best is yet to come. It is indeed the greatest invention of all the time. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below.
Top 10 upcoming trial vaccines for COVID-19. More than 150 coronavirus vaccines are in development across the world, and hopes are high to bring one to market in record time to ease the global crisis. Several efforts are underway to help make that possible, including the United States government's Operation Warp Speed Initiative, which has pledged $10 billion and aims to develop and deliver 300 million doses of a safe, effective coronavirus vaccine by January 2021. The World Health Organization is also coordinating global efforts to develop a vaccine, with an eye toward delivering 2 billion doses by the end of 2021. Here are the top 10 list of upcoming trial vaccines for COVID-19. Vaccine number 10, BNT162b2. This vaccine candidate relies on injecting snippets of a virus's genetic material, in this case messenger RNA, into human cells. It spares the production of viral proteins that mimic the coronavirus, training the immune system to recognize its presence. On November 20, Pfizer and BioNTech said they were filing for emergency authorization from the FDA, just 2 days after announcing the conclusion of their phase 3 trials. The companies stated that they've met their primary goals. The analysis found the candidate to be 95% effective in preventing mild and serious cases of COVID-19, and 94% effective in adults over 65 years old with no serious safety concerns. Vaccine number 9, CHAdOX1-nCoV-19. Oxford's candidate is what's known as a viral vector vaccine, essentially a Trojan horse presented to the immune system. Oxford's research team has transferred the SARS-CoV-2 spike protein, which helps the coronavirus invade cells, into a weakened version of an adenovirus, which typically causes the common cold. When this adenovirus is injected into humans, the hope is that the spike protein will trigger an immune response. AstraZeneca and Oxford plan to produce 1 billion doses of vaccine that they've agreed to sell at cost. On November 23, Oxford and AstraZeneca announced interim results from 2 of its phase 3 trials. One conducted in the United Kingdom showed the vaccine was 90% effective in preventing COVID-19 when given as a half dose followed by a full dose 1 month later. But in a second trial conducted in Brazil, in which volunteers received 2 full doses 1 month apart, the effectiveness dropped to 62%. Vaccine number 8, CoronaVac. CoronaVac is an inactivated vaccine that uses a non-infectious version of the coronavirus to provoke an immune response. On November 17, preliminary results from Sinovac's early trials, published in The Lancet, reported that the vaccine was safe but produced only a moderate immune response, with lower levels of antibodies compared to those in patients who have recovered from COVID-19. CoronaVac entered phase 3 trials in July, with plans to recruit nearly 9,000 healthcare professionals in Brazil, in addition to phase 3 trials in Indonesia and Bangladesh. Preliminary results in macaque monkeys, published in Science, revealed that the vaccine produced antibodies that neutralized 10 strains of SARS-CoV-2. Vaccine number 7, mRNA-1273. This vaccine candidate also relies on injecting snippets of mRNA into human cells to trigger an immune response. This vaccine requires 2 doses, 4 weeks apart. On November 16, Moderna announced that an interim analysis of its phase 3 study shows the vaccine is 94.5% effective in preventing COVID-19, including severe cases of the disease without any significant safety concerns. Like Pfizer, Moderna has not presented underlying data on how the vaccine produced these effects. In a separate announcement, the company also said its vaccine can be safely stored on ice or in a normal refrigerator for 30 days. Moderna intends to apply for an emergency use authorization with the FDA in the coming weeks. Vaccine number 6, Sputnik V. Gamaleya has developed a viral vector vaccine that also uses a weakened version of the common cold-causing adenovirus to introduce the SARS-CoV-2 spike protein to the body. This vaccine uses 2 strains of adenovirus, and it requires a second injection after 21 days to boost the immune response. On November 11, 2 days after Pfizer's announcement of its interim results, Gamaleya reported that an interim analysis of its phase 3 trial found 92% efficacy of the Sputnik vaccine. The report was only based on 20 cases, however, which experts say is too few to be convincing. In August, Russia cleared the Sputnik V vaccine for widespread use and claimed it as the first registered COVID-19 vaccine on the market, before the vaccine's phase 3 trials had begun, and despite the lack of published evidence at the time. Vaccine number 5, Covaxin. Covaxin uses an inactivated, or non-infectious, form of the coronavirus that can no longer cause disease, but can still provoke an immune response. This vaccine requires 2 doses that are administered 14 days apart. Results posted online in September, but not yet peer-reviewed, show that the vaccine produced antibodies in monkeys. Bharat Biotech Executive Director Sai Prasad also told Reuters in October that preliminary results from early vaccine trials found more than 90% of human participants developed antibodies. On October 23, Bharat Biotech announced it has received approval to start phase 3 trials in 26,000 participants at more than 25 centers across India. Vaccine number 4, NVX-CoV-2373. Novavax has bioengineered the coronavirus's spike proteins, the parts that help the virus invade cells but cannot replicate or cause COVID-19. Its vaccine candidate combines those proteins into a knucklebone-shaped nanoparticle. This can be injected along with its proprietary Matrix-M adjuvant, a compound that stimulates immune cells to elicit an immune response. The vaccine is administered in 2 doses, 21 days apart. On September 24, Novavax announced the launch of its phase 3 trial in the United Kingdom, which will evaluate the vaccine in up to 10,000 people, both with and without underlying conditions. Up to 400 participants will also be vaccinated against the seasonal flu as part of a sub-study that will help determine whether it is safe to give patients both vaccines at the same time. Vaccine number 3, J&J-7843-6735. Johnson & Johnson is developing an adenovector vaccine, which introduces a piece of DNA from SARS-CoV-2 into the common cold-causing adenovirus that has been genetically changed so that it can't replicate in the body. This vaccine builds on the technology Johnson & Johnson used to develop an Ebola vaccine, as well as vaccine candidates for Zika and HIV. On September 23, Johnson & Johnson announced the launch of a Phase 3 ensemble trial to evaluate the safety of the vaccine, and how well it works among up to 60,000 adults from a variety of countries. The trial will include a significant representation from older populations and those with underlying conditions that make them more susceptible to COVID-19. On October 12, Johnson & Johnson announced that it has paused these trials for an independent safety review due to an unexplained illness in a participant. Vaccine number 2, Bacillus Calmette-Guerin brace. For nearly 100 years, the Bacillus Calmette-Guerin BCG vaccine has been used to prevent tuberculosis by exposing patients to a small dose of live bacteria. Evidence has emerged over the years that this vaccine may boost the immune system and help the body fight off other diseases as well. Researchers are investigating whether these benefits may also extend to SARS-CoV-2, and this trial has reached Phase 3 in Australia. In April, researchers from the Murdoch Children's Research Institute began a series of randomized controlled trials that will test whether BCG might work on the coronavirus as well. They aim to recruit 10,000 healthcare workers in the study. Vaccine number 1, AD5-nCoV. CanSino has also developed a viral vector vaccine using a weakened version of the adenovirus as a vehicle for introducing the SARS-CoV-2 spike protein to the body. Preliminary results from Phase 2 trials, published in The Lancet, have shown that the vaccine produces a significant immune responses in the majority of recipients after a single immunization. There were no serious adverse reactions documented. Though the company was still technically in Phase 2 of its trial, on June 25, CanSino became the first company to receive limited approval to use its vaccine in people. The Chinese government has approved the vaccine for military use only, for a period of 1 year. On August 15, Russian biopharmaceutical company, Petrovax, announced it had launched the first Phase 3 clinical trial of AD5-nCoV.
Thank you guys, for watching this video.
We hope you liked this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below in comment box.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel, and press the bell icon.
Take care of yourselves, friends and family members. Bye for now.
Adios amigos.
Top 10 fighter jets in the world today. Hello guys, the jet fighters have come to dominate the skies for the first time since they were in the form of the Messerschmitt Me-262 during World War II. Technology defines air superiority now. As the fighting environment evolves, a fighter has to handle much more than ever before quickly, since the tactical agility and ability to adapt future technologies are considered from the beginning. New areas of functionality will be easily incorporated to develop 6th-generation jet fighters. Here in this video, we will see the top 10 best fighter jets in the world today. On number 10, we have Mikoyan MiG-35. With the improvements on MiG-29M and MiG-29K, MiG-35 was described among the 4th-generation Russian fighter jets. MiG-35's new design includes primarily the 5th-generation intelligence surveillance systems compatible with applications of Russian and foreign weaponry, and interconnected range of defensive control systems to enhance combat sustainability. The new total design overruns the baseline design concepts and allows the new aircraft as their Western counterparts to undertake massive-scale multi-role missions. On number 9, F-16 Fighting Falcon. The F-16 is a single-engine, extremely versatile, supersonic, tactical fighter aircraft with multi-role capability. It is much smaller, lighter than its predecessors with improved aerodynamics and avionics, but uses advanced fly-by-wire FBW control to achieve improved flight performance. The F-16 also includes the first use of Relaxed Static Stability (RSS), in which a fighter aircraft is intentionally designed to be slightly aerodynamically unstable, it has developed into a reliable all-weather multi-role aircraft designed for an air fighter for supremacy. Since they approved production in 1976, over 4,600 aircrafts have been produced. When it comes to equipping an air force, the F-16 is the best choice since it is only half the cost when bought by the F-15 and less than half for its maintenance. On number 8, Dassault Rafale. Now this is an omni-role jet fighter with 1.8 Mach performance speed. The Rafale was designed as a modern and versatile jet fighter by a French aviation company called Dassault. Dassault has included some new avionics in the multi-role fighter aircraft. Looking at its overall multi-role design, it's evident that the designers have taken new measures to reduce the aircraft's radar cross-section. This is a very maneuverable aircraft. The Rafale can simultaneously track 40 targets and attack on 4 targets. Purchasers can equip the aircraft in 3 different versions: Rafale C, single seat; Rafale M, single seat carrier; and Rafale B, twin seat variant. The plane will hold up to the latest American F-16 and F-15 models. In the 21st century, the Dassault Rafale will be the backbone of French air power. On number 7, Eurofighter Typhoon. The Eurofighter Typhoon divides perception among experts of military aviation. Nevertheless, it is without question a multi-role fighter in active service that is among the most effective in the world. United Kingdom, Germany, Italy, and later Spain, as a joint effort, developed it. At the outset of the Dassault Rafale program, France was involved initially but separated shortly. The Typhoon is a highly qualified and remarkably agile dogfighter. Nonetheless, the new American fighter jets F-22 Raptor and F-35 are considered more powerful and technologically advanced. But other than F-15 Rafale and Su-27, many experts find Eurofighter more capable. We expect the Typhoon to remain operational in the late 2030s when either the new generation fighter or the BAE Tempest replaces it. On number 6, Sukhoi Su-35. The multi-role Su-35 is a well-designed, improved variant of Su-27. The Russian Air Force introduced Su-35, the fourth generation fighter, in 2012. It's a highly maneuverable and agile fighter with a long range, high altitude, and massive artillery capabilities. Astonishingly, Sukhoi also has an air-to-ground secondary capability and can carry many weapons. It has 12 hardpoints for the wing and fuselage and can bear weight up to 8,000 kg in weight. The Sukhoi S-35 can reach up to supersonic speeds even without an afterburner, which makes it one of the fastest fighter jets. On number 5, Boeing F-18 Super Hornet. In 2001, the Super Hornet entered service with the US Navy, replacing the 2006 withdrawn Grumman F-14 Tomcat. The F-18 Hornet is widely regarded as the most versatile multi-role aircraft in the United States Navy and Marine Corps. For many years and in many war areas around the world, it has performed with distinction. The first battle was during Libya's 1986 bombing, and it also played a major role in the Gulf War of 1991. On number 4, Chengdu J-20. The Chengdu J-20 is the newest addition of Chinese fighter jets. Many experts speculate that the Russian MiG aviation company has supported the production of the Chengdu J-20. The initial low-rate development of this stealthy aircraft began in 2015. In 2016, the Chinese Air Force received its first operational J-20 stealth fighters. In 2017, China's Air Force officially adopted this stealthy fighter.
The J-20 is designed with precision strike capability as an air superiority fighter. Chengdu J-20 uses retractable guided missile launchers that come out on rails, enabling the internal weapons bay to be closed down while the missiles are still hanging outside. It entered the service of the People's Liberation Army Air Force in March 2017 as an air superiority fighter. On number 3, Sukhoi Su-57. Su-57 is intended as the first modern fighter jet to use stealth technology in the Russian military service. Sukhoi delivered the first aircraft of production in 2019 with a second in 2020. The jet is intended to overcome the previous generation fighter plane with super maneuverability, stealth and advanced avionics. Sukhoi has designed the aircraft to carry out air defense and to attack missions the Russian Air Force and the Russian Navy mainly. It can defend all kinds of enemy targets for ground, air and surface locations and monitor long distances in the Russian airspace. On number 2, Lockheed Martin F-35B Lightning II. This is a 5th-generation single-seat and single-engine all-weather stealth multi-role combat aircraft family for ground assault and air superiority operations. F-35 Lightning II is the world's first international multi-role 5th-generation most powerful fighter jet. The aircraft descends down from the Lockheed Martin X-35, competing against Boeing X-32 in 2001 to win the Joint Strike Fighter program. A tactical advantage over all other battle aviation is provided by the highly agile, stealthy design alongside an advanced sensor pack and modern weapon systems. As the biggest and most expensive combat initiative, the F-35 was the subject of a lot of scrutiny and criticism in the United States and everywhere else. On top 1, Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor. The F-22 Raptor, developed by Lockheed Martin and Boeing, is a single-seat, twin-engine, fifth-generation, extremely advanced tactical fighter. The stealth, extremely advanced avionics, and higher performance like thrust-to-weight ratio with speed make this modern marvel a super maneuverable dogfighter. Originally an air superiority fighter, it can additionally perform many other functions, including ground attack, electronic warfare, and signal intelligence. The F-22 cannot be exported under the US federal law to protect its stealth technology and other high-tech features. Lockheed designed it to be highly difficult to detect and track by radar, with turbines from any outside view are all measures to reduce radar cross-sections and the use of radar observant material. The F-22 also has reduced radio emissions, infrared signatures and acoustic indications and extremely low naked eye visibility. Flat thrust vectoring nozzles minimize infrared exhaust emissions to reduce the risk of surface-to-air and air-to-air missiles that use infrared homing. The F-22 began life as a straightforward air superiority fighter. Besides, this airplane has faced a formidable air threat from the fighters of other countries since its launch. It later switched to the multi-role combatant with extra capacity for ground attack. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below.
Top 10 most dangerous places in the world. Listen guys, it is always important to know about the place you are in when you travel a lot or just go on vacation for a couple of days every time. In all forms and types, traveling could sometimes be hazards. One nation could be torn by war and filled with distressed people, while we might know one for theft and violence on the road. These are the top 10 most dangerous places in the world in 2020. On number 10, Gaza Strip. A 25-mile stretch of land is home to around 1.8 million people and is one of the most densely populated areas in the world, the Gaza Strip and the West Bank. Although the area is no longer under Israeli occupation, it is still under strict border control. The Israeli army conducts raids within the area to counter Hamas terrorists, who have support from Arabic nations, and Salafi jihadists, from inside the border who are carrying out attacks toward Israel.
when most brutal conflicts take place, those touring Gaza should remain back from protests and off the roads in the evening. Areas close to the frontier are susceptible to shooting and airstrikes, while police facilities and public structures are often sites for both terrorists and Israeli operations on a larger scale.
On number 9, Natal.
Natal City is on Brazil's Atlantic coast. The city's sites include beautiful beaches, historic sites, and shopping malls. It used to be among the best tourist destinations in South America. But in recent years, there are some signs and hazards in this so-called suntown, as the eye-catching beaches in the city have become a hub for robberies. Many cases have been recorded by oceanfront tourists that muggers notice individual people with a camera and precious stuff. Blackmailing at gunpoint for robbery and some of the worst situations you can face, that's why authorities suggest walking in a group with a local person will be a better idea. Police officers also harass tourists to bribe them with fake charges or violations of minor rules. Thus, with the regular headlines of gang violence and corruption, the Brazilian city is astonishing. The city's murder rate is around 103 per lakh. This way, Brazil is shattering its murder record. This also involves murder by police officers' hands. In the latest moments, the amount of rapes and murders of women has also increased.
On number 8, Mogadishu.
International media often term Somalia the most dangerous country in the world, which is surrounded by violence and war. It's a pirate hotspot, and these modern pirates kidnap people and demand ransom in exchange to release. Somalia's capital city, Mogadishu, has seen decades of war and has only lately started healing. Unfortunately, there is still unrest because of the Islamist militant group supported by Al-Qaeda, Al-Shabaab, as pirates continue to terrorize the region. The average ransom settlement received by pirates in Somalia between 2005 and 2012 was $2.7 million, according to a report published by Interpol, the United Nations, and the World Bank. There's been an estimate of an amount between $339 million and $413 million in total ransom deals taken to the pirates during that period.
On number 7, Iraq.
The country has become one of the most dangerous places in the world since the Baghdad attack in 2003. It's almost 15 years the country has been broken apart from countless wars, corrupt politicians, and Islamic terrorists. Since 2012, large-scale assaults in Baghdad have been on the rise following a lull in brutality. Is a highly volatile scenario, where the risk of a terrorist attack or kidnapping is possible, as many authorities request tourists to stay away from this region. Just not to go there is a common approach to stay safe in Baghdad, and it is harmful, sometimes deadly, to move outside the safe zone. Roadside car bombings in Baghdad and towns such as Ramadi, Fallujah are regular events. And while the trend seemed to turn against ISIS, the terrorist organization still controls Iraq's second largest town, Mosul, in 2020.
On number 6, Helmand Province, Afghanistan.
The Afghan war has become the longest conflict in the history of the United States. Not only has the war become more intense over time, but it has become more complex. Assaults from all sides are getting bigger, more frequent, wider, and much more destructive. Both powers, the Taliban backed by all regional Islamic terrorists and the Afghan government backed by the US and NATO, are trying to get the upper hand. Both sides are trying in their favor to break the stalemate, as each side wants to increase its impact and seize more territory. The Taliban wants to increase its leverage as the concept of peace negotiations has gained momentum and talk from a place of authority at the negotiating panel. Also, the growing tension between the US and regional powers, particularly Pakistan, Russia, and Iran, has a negative effect. This international tension made this nation a proxy battleground, labeling it as the most dangerous country in the world to live.
On number 5, Tijuana, Mexico.
Tijuana is one of Mexico's fastest growing cities and is the world's most frequented border city. Many Americans travel across the border to this town every day to experience the Mexican culture. The city's nightlife, palm bars, spicy food, and hotels add more elegance to it. The citizens of this city know of the real risks, though. An initiative has been made by the US State Department based on the increasing city's violent crime rate. Although the town had forever been a safe location, the circumstances have changed a lot now, and Tijuana has become Mexico's crime point after Juarez. Many pickpockets and purse snatchers have settled their base in public places and beautiful tourist spots. The city also acts as a place for trafficking in human beings and narco violence by big Mexican cartels. Tijuana's most scary fact is the very high murder rate of 101 murders per lakh people.
On number 4, Sana'a, Yemen.
Because of the continual attacks, assassination, and random bombings, it serves as a battleground for global proxy wars. For its unique design, the ancient town of Sana'a has a distinctive architectural element and is one of the tourist spots in the Middle East. but is also renowned as one of the world's most politically volatile locations you've ever been able to stay in. The US State Department advises its people not to travel to the region. This is because there is frequent conflict between protesters and government forces as the situation goes out of control within minutes.
On number 3rd, Los Cabos, Mexico.
Mexico's Los Cabos City is a beautiful resort town. But in the last years is accompanied by several killings, the town has become the world's number one dangerous city by the murder rate. It is no longer the status of the city as a peaceful gateway by covering too much violence over the town to which the drug cartels performed a major part. The number of killings in the town is skyrocketing as time goes on. According to recent events, Los Cabos has a homicide rate of 112 per 1 lakh people. In this city, lakes, restaurants, and vacationers are not safe. The sands of beaches are not safe, as they show the scattered blood spots showcasing the level of slaughter in the city. Gang violence is also a significant cause of the city's increased crime level. The authorities ensure that tourists are warned beforehand and suggested staying away from the town, given the city's amazing beauty.
On number 2nd, Damascus, Syria.
This could be a fighting ground for the entire world, as this crisis has gone beyond jihad versus government matter. The dispute over the supposed chemical arms assault on rebels by Syrian President Bashar al-Assad in the Douma district of Damascus is only the latest chapter in this story. As a common uprising against a dictatorial regime, the Syrian conflict started 7 years ago. Before morphing into a chain of proxy wars, this peaceful uprising quickly became a civil war with religious tones added later. Saudi Arabia and its allies supported the battle against Assad through Sunni militias, terrorists, as Assad is an Alawite Muslim, offshoot of Shia Muslims, rivals of Sunni Muslims. The US attempted to find moderate rebel groups with a small success that it could support and help them. In Syria, Kurdish groups made deals first with Assad and later with the US. Turkey was funding and arming its own militias, partly to preserve influence in a country that was historically part of its empire, partly to combat the Kurds.
On number 1st, Venezuela.
It all started after Socialist Democratic candidate Hugo Chavez won his first presidential term in 1999. As with all socialist democracies, citizens were happy initially until Venezuela's economy started its downfall from 2013. His successor Nicolas Maduro, who unsurprisingly took over the control, precipitated Venezuela's economic downfall, which ignited an economic crisis. Naturally, like any other communist government, he refused to give up his presidential seat, which ultimately led to total collapse. According to the Venezuelan Violence Observatory, this country has been in a state of crisis for years, grounded in political unrest, mass protests, water, medication shortages, rising drug trafficking, and has one of the highest murder levels in the globe. Venezuela's insecurity highlights a bigger pattern in Latin America and the Caribbean, suffering from ever high rates of insecurity. Collectively, over the previous 2 years, the area has had the lowest ratings for law and order. According to the study, 42% of Venezuelans had stolen property or money in 2017, and almost 25% of Venezuelans were assaulted, one of the highest attack rates in the world. While nearly 70% of individuals surveyed were confident in their local police across all 142 nations, that amount dropped to 24% for Venezuelans. Thank you guys for watching this video.
We hope you liked this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below in comment box.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon.
Take care of yourselves, friends and family members. Bye for now.
Adios amigos.
Top 10 most expensive house in the world.
Hello guys. Welcome to Just Top 10. A house is a place where happiness is celebrated, whether there is someone born or somebody married. The same applies to the elites, but with a difference. Many of us paddle along with mortgage payments and the like, without thinking a little about the matter. Billionaires are free to buy some of the most extravagant and magnificent homes. Wasting no moment, check out this list of the top 10 most expensive houses in the world.
On number 10, Ellison Estate.
Located in the Woodside is this $200 million estate, owned by Larry Ellison, the co-founder of Oracle. Due to its value, this estate holds 10 different properties, a man-made lake, tea house and bathhouse, all with an immaculate lodge-like design in and out. With stone fireplaces, comfy velvet sofas and wooden pillars, this estate is the ultimate wooden property with outstanding lake views.
On number 9, 220 Central Park South penthouse.
History was made when hedge fund billionaire Ken Griffin purchased the 24,000 square foot penthouses overlooking New York Central Park,
for $238 million, making it the most expensive home sold in the United States. Famous architect Robert A. M. Stern designed this building. The 79-story tall skyscraper is unique and distinct compared to other buildings in Manhattan. It is due to the building is sheathed with Alabama Silver Shadow Limestone. The building has lots of luxurious amenities, including a spa, an exclusive sporting club, private dining space, private motor court, and lots of entertainment facilities. On number 8, 4 Fairfield Pond. We knew New York would pop up eventually. This 63-acre property is the home of Ira Renner, owner of the Renko Group, a holding investment company in auto manufacturing and smelting. With 29 bedrooms, 3 light-up swimming pools, a 91-foot dining room, and its very own power plant, this home is definitely an expensive one. What's more? It's a great bit of land for those who are sporty and active, as it also boasts a basketball court, bowling alley, squash courts, and tennis courts. Wow! In addition to this, 4 Fairfield Pond has a property value of $248.5 million. On number 7, Palais Boule. The Palais Boule, which has been designed by Hungarian architect Andy Lovig and constructed between 1975 and 1989, is a large house at the Théâtre-sur-Mer, near Cannes, France. It was built for a French industrialist and later purchased as a holiday home by the billionaire fashion designer Pierre Cardin. What's so special? The Bubble Palace has a range of round rooms and overlooks the Mediterranean Sea and a rocky cliff. The architect Lovig is reported to have been inspired by the earliest dwellings on caves, could be a possible reason behind its unusual design. Located by the seafront estate, with 3 pools, a number of gardens, and an amphitheater on the hillside grounds, the house is not short on modern comforts. On number 6, Odeon Tower Penthouse. The 5-story penthouse, covering 35,500 square feet, is one of the world's most expensive properties if valued per square meter. It is located in the second tallest building on the European Mediterranean coastline. The Tour Odeon Sky Penthouse takes luxurious lavish living to new standards. The majestic penthouse stands above the azure waters of the Mediterranean. Odeon Tower Penthouse has unparalleled 360-degree views over the ocean, with an amazing outdoor, infinite, circular, roof swimming pool, linked to the balcony by a water slide. On number 5, Whittenhurst. Whittenhurst is a large Grade II, listed 1930s, Georgian Revival mansion, located on 5 acres in Highgate, northwest London. The house has had several prominent owners since being rebuilt by the soap magnate Sir Arthur Crossfield, and after several decades of increasing dilapidation, it underwent substantial refurbishment after its 2008 sale to an offshore company owned by the family of the Russian businessman Andrei Guryev. The mansion has 65 rooms spread across 3 floors, including 25 bedrooms. One of the largest is the ballroom, measuring 70 feet long with a height of 20 feet. It has oak flooring and the timber wall panels are in walnut, with carved cornices, embellished with gold leaf. Other rooms are the drawing room, study, entrance hall and staircase, and most of the bedrooms are all in an opulent classical style. Other richly decorated rooms include the dining room, Chinese room, billiard room, and the gallery hallway. Access to the property is via a 3-fingered gatehouse. On number 4, Villa Les Cedres. Located in Saint-Jean-Cap-Ferrat, France. Estimated at $450 million, this home getting close to being worth almost half a billion dollars. It was first built in 1830 and purchased by King Leopold II of Belgium in 1904. It was previously considered to be the most expensive house on the market back in 2017, but has since been overtaken by the next 3 properties on the list. The property is set on approximately 35 acres of gardens, and its name derives from the many cedar trees located throughout its grounds. The house itself is roughly 18,000 square feet and consists of 14 bedrooms. It also has an Olympic-sized swimming pool and a large stable, big enough for 30 horses. On number 3, Villa Leopolda. The villa is owned by the widow, Lily Safra, of Lebanese-Brazilian banker, Edmond Safra. It's located in the Francis Alps Maritime Department of its Côte d'Azur region, and occupies approximately 50 acres. It has 11 bedrooms, 14 bathrooms, a commercial greenhouse, helipad, outdoor kitchen, and one of the nicest swimming pools you'll ever see. The property is famous in itself, as it was the setting for Alfred Hitchcock's 1955 film, To Catch a Thief. The house's name comes from its original owner, King Leopold II of Belgium, and was redesigned in the 1920s by American architect Ogden Codman Jr. On number 2, Antilia. Valued at 82 billion Indian rupees, This is quite possibly the most extravagant property in the whole world. Whilst building a 27-story home in one of the most poverty-stricken areas in the world, might sound slightly and harshly boastful, Mukesh Ambani, India's richest man, thinks otherwise. The home is 400,000 square foot with 27 high ceilings, and it has been brought to light that the building can survive a deadly earthquake. We seriously don't want to miss a single feature out for this home, so we decided to put it into a list instead. 3 rooftop helicopter pads, 9 high-speed elevators, a steel and glass structure, 2-story health center containing an indoor swimming pool and jacuzzi, 6 of the floors are a family residence dedicated to his family, houses for the staff, an entire floor is dedicated to the servicing of his cars, 50-seat home theater with a wine room, snack bar and entertainment space, dance studio, 6-story parking accommodating a maximum of 68 cars. Wow, man! On top 1, Buckingham Palace. Coming in at number 1 on the list, and claiming the title of the most expensive house in the world, is Buckingham Palace. The palace is owned by the British royal family, and is one of a number of lavish properties in their portfolio. It is located in the city of Westminster, London, and comprises of 775 rooms, 78 bathrooms, 92 offices, and 19 staterooms. It's been the official residence of the monarchy since 1873. In terms of size, the palace checks in at approximately 828,000 square feet and the garden alone is 40 acres. However, despite its impressive size and taking the title of the most expensive house in the world, it's still not the largest palace in the world. It's estimated that if the palace were to be put up for sale, it would be somewhere in the region of $2.9 billion, but it's highly unlikely it will ever happen. Thank you guys, for watching this video.
We hope you liked this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below in comment box.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel, and press the bell icon.
Take care of yourselves, friends and family members. Bye for now.
Adios amigos.
Top 10 Most Visited Tourist Countries in the World.
Hello friends, welcome to Just Top 10. In a time where travel bloggers and international travelers flood our social media feeds with incredible tales of their holidays, you can't help but wonder just what is the most visited country in the world. Which stunning scenery do we need to see? Where do we pin on the world map next? What are the top travel destinations? If you're looking to update your bucket list, look no further than the following countries mentioned in this video. Make your vacation days count by leaping between these lily pads of diverse terrains and rich histories. Don't forget to share this video with your travel buddies with whom you want to visit these places. Now, without further ado, let's start our video. Bang bang!
On number 10, let's start with, United Kingdom.
Afternoon tea, posh accents and of course the Queen, have built Britain into an image of refined elegance, and made it in this top 10 of the most visited countries in the world. There is also the moody Scotland and Wales, and down-to-earth Northern Ireland. Combining the historical sites of local flavor under the United Kingdom banner, we have ourselves a myriad of landing points. In the list of famous attractions of United Kingdom, we have following destinations.
Buckingham Palace.
Buckingham Palace is the London residence and administrative headquarters of the monarch of the United Kingdom.
Westminster Abbey.
A royal church offering daily services for all and a World Heritage Site with over 1,000 years of history. Coronations, royal weddings, kings, queens, statesmen and soldiers, poets, heroes and villains, history happens here and it's all waiting to be discovered.
Stonehenge.
Uncover the story of Stonehenge. Take in the unforgettable atmosphere of this World Heritage Site and best-known prehistoric monument in Europe, visit the world-class exhibition to discover how the Stonehenge builders worked and walk amongst the Neolithic houses to experience how they lived.
Edinburgh Castle.
Edinburgh Castle is a historic fortress which dominates the skyline of Edinburgh, the capital city of Scotland, from its position on the Castle Rock. Archaeologists have established human occupation of the rock since at least the Iron Age, although the nature of the early settlement is unclear.
Roman Baths.
It is a major tourist attraction in the UK, and together with the Grand Pump Room, receives more than 1.3 million visitors annually. Visitors can tour the baths and museum but cannot enter the water.
On number 9, we have Thailand.
Thailand has been a popular tourist destination for decades thanks to its white sand beaches, delicious cuisine and hot weather. Bangkok, Thailand's capital, frequently holds the top spot as the world's most visited city. It attracts around 22 million visitors each year. The 1,430 islands of Thailand draw in hundreds of thousands of visitors each year. Some of the islands are heralded as being some of the best in the world. In the list of famous attractions of Thailand, we have following places to must see when visit Thailand.
Wat Pha.
Wat Pha, the Temple of the Reclining Buddha, is right behind the Temple of the Emerald Buddha. It's a must-see for any first-time visitor to Bangkok. As one of the largest temple complexes in the city, it's famed for its giant reclining Buddha that is 46 meters long, covered in gold leaf.
Grand Palace.
Make no mistake, Bangkok's Grand Palace is the busiest tourist stop in the city. Day after day, it's swarming with tourists from all parts of the world who scramble for some Thai history and culture as they bake in the heat.
Chiang Mai.
With beautiful nature blended with Lhana culture and colors of contemporary perfectly, Chiang Mai is therefore a province that has many tourists, both Thai and foreigners, come in many millions each year. Do not miss to shop, art products, taste local cuisine and see cultures on Nim Anh Min Road.
Erawan National Park.
Erawan National Park is in Thailand, northwest of Bangkok, near the Myanmar-Burma border. It's known for Erawan Falls, which cascades down 7 tiers. The park's many caves include Phardap Cave, which has stalactites and stalagmites, and Ta Duang Cave, featuring rock paintings.
Phuket Region.
Phuket, a rainforested, mountainous island in the Andaman Sea, has some of Thailand's most popular beaches, mainly situated along the clear waters of the western shore. The island is home to many high-end seaside resorts, spas and restaurants.
On number 8, we have Germany.
Germany may be remembered as the set of horrific tragedy, but it is also the birthplace of great thinkers, inventors and creatives who ushered in the modern era. Cast your eyes beyond the Romanesque and Baroque build of Berlin, Munich, and Hamburg to see the swaying path into rural Germany. The valleys unfold into imposing forests and vast vineyards, reaching towards northern dunes and chilly Alps. Stretch your senses, eyes and tongue, to taste Germany's regional diversity. Germany is famous for its beer, sausages and picturesque castles. The country welcomes around 39 million tourists each year, with approximately 13 million visiting Berlin, Germany's capital city. Tourism in Germany generates 2 million jobs for its residents and contributes over 4% towards the country's GDP. In the list of famous attractions of Germany, one should must visit the following places while visiting Germany.
Pergamon Museum.
The Pergamon Museum is located on Museum Island in Berlin, Germany. The museum is famous for housing large monumental historic Babylonian, Greek and Roman buildings such as the Ishtar Gate of Babylon, the Pergamon Altar and the Market Gate of Miletus. Pergamon Museum has 3 separate museums, the Collection of Classical Antiquities, the Museum of the Ancient Near East, and the Museum of Islamic Art.
Schloss Neuschwanstein.
Set amidst a breathtaking setting, Neuschwanstein Castle is one of Germany's most romantic and famous attractions. Built from 1869 to 1886 under King Ludwig II, the palace, also known as the Sleeping Beauty Castle, is located near the village of Hohenschwangau and the town of Fussen, by the Austrian border in Bavaria. Every year, 1.5 million visitors stop by Neuschwanstein.
Zwinger.
This architectural masterpiece is one of Europe's foremost late Baroque buildings. The Crown Gate, Kronentor, with its golden dome has become a famous Dresden landmark. Originally designed as an orangery and a setting for court festivities, it was later used for exhibitions. Most perfect example of late Baroque architecture in Germany.
Kölner Dom.
Cologne Cathedral is a building of superlatives that is the center and hallmark of this city on the Rhine. Because of these relics, the cathedral became one of the most important places of pilgrimage in Europe. Its 2 massive towers have dominated the city's skyline since their completion in 1880.
On number 7, we have Mexico.
Mexico, located in the southern part of North America, is rapidly becoming a favorite tourist destination. People from all over the world are visiting the vibrant country to enjoy the pristine beaches, explore the deep history and culture, and discover UNESCO World Heritage Sites. Over the last decade, tourism has significantly contributed to Mexico's employment and economy. In 2019, the government announced a six-year strategy to boost tourism and improve conditions for workers within the industry. In the list of famous attractions of Mexico, one should must visit the following places.
Tulum.
Tulum is known for being one of the last cities built and occupied by the Mayans. The ruins to the north of the city and other archaeological sites have become popular tourist destinations and will fill you with wonder. Tulum is a small city on the Yucatan Peninsula renowned for its stunning beaches.
Cabo Pulmo.
Rated as one of Mexico's top 5 tourist destinations, Cabo is known for its beaches, scuba diving locations, balnearios, the Ch. El Arco de Cabo San Lucas, and marine life.
Palenque Ruins.
Ancient Mayan town of Palenque is nestled in the foothills of Chiapas Mountains, and is surrounded by the remains of virgin forest. Palenque competes with its Guatemalan rival Tikal for the post of the most beautiful Mayan ruins.
Teotihuacan.
Admire the beauty of Teotihuacan from a hot air balloon. The ancient city of Teotihuacan is as mysterious as it is grandiose. While climbing the pyramids is a great way of exploring it, there is another way that will most surely blow your mind, hovering over it on a hot air balloon.
Palacio de Bellas Artes.
The Palacio de Bellas Artes, Palace of Fine Arts, is a prominent cultural center in Mexico City. It has hosted some of the most notable events in music, dance, theater, opera and literature and has held important exhibitions of painting, sculpture and photography. Consequently, the Palacio de Bellas Artes has been called the Cathedral of Art in Mexico.
Edzna, Oaxaca City.
Edzna is a Maya archaeological site in the north of the Mexican state of Campeche. Today, the site is open to visitors. The most remarkable building at the site is the main temple located at the plaza. Built on a platform 40 meters high, it provides a wide overview of the surroundings. Another significant building located in the plaza is a ball court. Two parallel structures make up the ball court. The top rooms of the ball court were possibly used to store images of the gods associated with the events, along with items needed for the games.
On number 6, we have Turkey.
Located on two continents, Turkey offers a unique blend of East and West. Edged by the Mediterranean and Aegean Seas, Turkey has an abundance of stunning coastlines and charming resorts. Tourists also enjoy visiting Turkey's capital. It was reported that over 15 million vacationers visited Antalya in 2019. Antalya is popular, thanks to its close proximity to beaches and remnants of Turkey's rich history. Having been conquered by the Romans, Byzantines, and Ottomans, Turkey treks its story from fervent Istanbul to the romantic Mediterranean coast. On the way are magical landscapes that range from jutting rock formations to glittering lakes and olive groves. Explore these settings via canyoning, kayaking, paragliding, hiking and more adventurous means. In the list of famous attractions of Turkey, one should must visit the following places.
Topkapi Palace.
Istanbul's Topkapi Palace is full of awe-inspiring ceilings like. The site is huge, you really need the best part of a day to explore the four main courtyards and various museums and historic buildings and pavilions, many of which were constructed and adapted over the centuries.
Süleymaniye Mosque.
The mosque was built by the Ottoman Sultan Suleiman and the mosque was named after him. The mosque is located at the highest end of the city of Istanbul. It is designed to glorify the Sultan. The architecture and craftsmanship of the mosque are very beautiful and attract many worshippers and visitors.
Hagia Sophia.
This heavenly building served as both church and mosque. The name Hagia Sophia comes from Greek for holy wisdom. It was the largest cathedral in the world for 1,000 years, until 1520, and has been the inspiration for countless other buildings, including the beloved Sultan Ahmed Mosque which faces it right across a garden. Can you believe that a structure so old and tall could endure for a millennium and a half?
Bergama Acropolis.
A city devoted to Aphrodite, the goddess of love and beauty, has had over 200,000 visitors last year and signs show that growth is imminent. Pergamon was inscribed in the UNESCO World Heritage List in 2014, and it has been one of the rare settlements that has survived several invasions and devastations over the ages, but reoccupied again on the merits of its strategic location.
Caves of Heaven and Hell.
The Caves of Heaven and Hell, 1 mile northwest of Narlıkuyu, on Turkey's Mediterranean coast, are worth a visit as natural phenomena, and also as historical points of interest. Heaven and Hell are two enormous caves, and it is here that you visit Heaven on Earth. The road to hell is a bit more complicated, and unfortunately it is impossible to end up in hell, because there is no path that leads you to the bottom of this cave.
Nemrut Doggy National Park.
No photos can do justice to the haunting reality of this bare, windy, isolated mountaintop with its strange, gravel-covered, 50 meters high burial cone and the presence of those pitilessly staring statues with their partly mutilated, partly weathered features. Mount Nemrut of Adyaman is fabulous both at sunrise and sunset, with statues of ancient gods whispering into your ear to wow you.
On number 5, we have Italy.
Italy has culture, history and cuisine in abundance, making it a very popular tourist destination for people all around the globe. Italy has a varied landscape that suits all traveler types. There are snow-covered peaks, sprawling vineyards and glittering coastlines. Not to mention the beautiful cities like Rome, Naples, and Florence. There are 50 UNESCO World Heritage sites dotted throughout the country showcasing the best of Italian history. The arts come to mind when we think of Italy, the fifth most visited country in this world, of the Byzantine architectures, Padua's frescoes, Michelangelo's David and the greatest of Da Vinci's works. On the more natural spectrum is extraordinary geological diversity. In the list of famous attractions of Italy, one should must visit the following places.
Roman Forum.
The Roman Forum is a true sanctuary of the ancient Rome, a valuable source of information if you are interested in the history of the Roman Empire. It is also the place where the life of citizens was developed, politics, justice, commerce, social life and worship of the gods. This was the heart of the city of Rome.
Tuscany's vineyards.
Tuscany has long been associated with breathtaking scenery and some of Italy's best made wines. In this enchanting landscape of rolling hills and winding roads, you'll find glorious sunflower fields, ancient olive groves, medieval ruins, and wonderfully wild forests. And, of course, world-class wineries.
Ruins of Pompeii.
One should must explore the ancient ruins of Pompeii. Enjoy skip the line access to the ruins and discover what life was like before the catastrophic eruption of Mount Vesuvius in AD 79. Follow your archaeologist guide around the western part of the town and see important buildings and structures such as the Basilica, the Forum, the thermal baths, a brothel, some residential homes, and more.
Amalfi Coast.
Discovering the divine between picturesque landscapes and untouched nature. The Amalfi Coast, with its panoramic views, a sea of dreams and ancient palaces and gardens as Villa Ruffolo or Villa Cimbrone, ranks among the top destinations most appreciated by Italian and foreign tourists.
St. Peter's Basilica.
Such wonderful beauty to behold. The space around the main altar inside St. Peter's Basilica. St. Peter's Basilica is deemed to be one of the holiest sites in all of the world, by many Christians and the principal church of one of the most powerful men on earth, the Pope.
Duomo.
The Duomo di Milano is a beautiful site and definitely worth exploring. And Milan itself has much to offer the visitor during their Italian vacation. As well as this beautiful Gothic cathedral, there's the Galleria Vittorio, the oldest shopping mall in the world and La Scala Opera House.
On number 4, here it comes, the People's Republic of China.
China, the third largest country in the world, is in the world's top 5 tourist destinations because of its natural landscapes, expansive history and delicious cuisine. Tourism in China is a growing industry that is becoming a significant part of the country's economy. In 2018, tourism contributed 11.04% of China's overall GDP, which increased a further 1.2% in 2019. It is impossible to capture neither China's vastness nor the breadth of its existence. It is this indelible quality that lures you in over and again. When you've had your fill of modern malls and artifact-filled museums, spare time for China's magnificent landscapes. Choose between Yangshuo's winding rivers, Hong Kong's concrete junglescape, haunting Mongolia deserts, and the floral crown of Qinghai Lake. Regardless, if you come for the scenery, you stay for the food, for China's culinary variations mean anything can be eaten and eaten with relish. In the list of famous attractions of China, one should must visit the following places.
Forbidden City.
There is no shortage of impressive interiors at Beijing's Forbidden City, a complex of 980 buildings covering 180 acres. This dome is just one. The Forbidden City was the home of China's emperors from the Ming Dynasty to the end of the Qing Dynasty, some 500 years. Built at the beginning of the 15th century, the compound contains nearly 1,000 buildings, making this perhaps the most grueling tourist site in the world. Be sure to stroll through the Palace Museum and the various pavilions, but do try to see the Hall of Supreme Harmony, the largest in the complex and the one containing the Dragon Throne where the Emperor once sat.
The Great Wall.
Great Wall of China is the structure that took the most hours of human effort. It took more than 2,000 years to complete. It was built across the historical northern borders of China to protect and consolidate territories of Chinese states and empire against various nomadic groups of the steppe and their polities. Several walls were being built from as early as the 7th century BC by ancient Chinese states. The Great Wall is believed to be more than 20,000 kilometers long. The length can be envisioned as the distance from Kochi to Delhi in a straight line.
Shanghai's French Concession.
The French Concession is the area of Shanghai once designated for the French, consisting of today's Luan and Shuhui districts. Luan's Waihai Road is a busy shopping street and is also home to both Xindiandi and Tianzi Fang, extremely popular shopping and dining spots for tourists.
Qin's Terracotta Warriors.
The Qin Emperor's terracotta figures, remarkably well preserved despite being over 2,000 years old, testify to the power of the man for whom they were molded to protect. This site is a stunning archaeological find of monumental scale, an amazing display that every visitor to China should see.
Li River.
For a glimpse of China's natural beauty, board a boat for a 4-hour cruise down the Li River to the picturesque city of Yangshuo. The beauty of Li River is in the reflection, and the most beautiful reflection is the reflection of Yellow Cloth Shoal. There is a maize yellow flagstone, long and wide, just like a yellow cloth spreads on the bottom of Li River, hence the name of Yellow Cloth Shoal.
Lishan's Grand Buddha.
Lishan is 30 kilometers east of Ma Shan. The giant attraction of the city is the world's largest Buddha statue. It is 71 meters high and you'll feel infinitely small just compared with one of the Buddha's toenails. The statue is carved out from the rocks at the confluence of the Dadu, Mingjiang, and Kuangyi rivers.
On number 3rd, we have United States of America.
Tourism is one of the United States' biggest contributors to the country's GDP. The industry supports over 7 million jobs, and in 2017, tourism generated $1.6 trillion in economic output. America has always been a popular travel destination due to its sprawl of metropolis and small town charms. Last year, it welcomed a rounded down number of 82 million visitors. With travel patterns trending toward city hopping and road tripping, America's endless highways are a siren's call. In the list of famous attractions of the United States, one should must visit the following places.
New York City.
New York City comprises 5 boroughs sitting where the Hudson River meets the Atlantic Ocean. At its core is Manhattan, a densely populated borough that's among the world's major commercial, financial and cultural centers. Its iconic sites include skyscrapers such as the Empire State Building and sprawling Central Park. Broadway Theater is staged in neon-lit Times Square.
Yellowstone National Park.
A chairlift carries skiers up Snow King Mountain in Jackson, Wyoming. More than a vacation wonderland, the Yellowstone region has become a magnet for people fleeing cities for a life closer to nature. It's one of the fastest growing rural areas in the US.
Grand Canyon.
Vast, magnificent and inarguably beautiful, the Grand Canyon is easily Arizona's most distinguishable landmark, a natural wonder you must see to believe. Stretching 277 miles from end to end, its rocky walls descend more than a mile to the canyon's floor, where the wild Colorado River traces a swift course southwest. Everyone should see the Grand Canyon at least once in their life. In 2019, the Grand Canyon celebrated its 100th birthday as a national park.
New Orleans.
Made up of several districts, New Orleans is anchored by the famed French Quarter. As the oldest and most visited part of New Orleans, the French Quarter is home to Creole cottages and colonial architecture that make up the many hotels, restaurants, bars, shops and jazz clubs. The galleries and boutiques of Royal Street by day give way to the raucous parties and curbside festivities of Bourbon Street at night. No matter where you go in the city, there will always be an attraction or event that is strictly New Orleans.
Miami beaches.
Miami Beach is the boiled down essence of Miami, with sunbaked beaches, sparkling hotel pools, and drumming nightlife. The action centers on South Beach, a high glamour hotspot chock full of luxury properties, celebrity chef outposts, and big name fashion. Poolside cabanas with HDTVs and butler service? No problem. But farther north, the scene mellows,
with plenty of family-friendly sunny spots.
On number second, we have Spain.
Spain is the second most visited country in both the world and Europe. Tourism accounts for 12% of Spain's economy and provides 13% of jobs. The majority of tourists who visit the country come from Europe. It is the warm weather, pristine beaches and bustling cities that attract millions of vacationers. Passion flares in Spain, a country crafted for the good life. Maybe that's why Spain wins the second place for the most visited countries in the world. Embark on an epic road trip looping from Barcelona to Madrid. Glimpses of Spain's enduring landscapes pass by like a photographer's reel. In the list of famous attractions of Spain, one should must visit the following places.
La Familia Sagrada.
Antoni Gaudí's unfinished masterpiece, La Sagrada Familia, is one of the world's most popular tourist attractions. The Sagrada Familia receives approximately 4.5 million visitors each year. One of the most beautiful features of the Sagrada Familia is Gaudí's use of light. The church has large stained glass windows which bathe the naves with color. The effect is most striking mid-morning and mid to late afternoon when sunlight strikes the windows directly.
Parc Güell.
Parc Güell was an attempt to create a housing estate in a natural setting in the old village of Gràcia, an ambitious property development project commissioned by Gaudí's patron, Eusebi Güell. Gaudí's characteristic vivid imagination is revealed in the different elements that amaze visitors from around the world that visit Barcelona.
The Alhambra.
The Alhambra in the city of Granada in Spain sits on top of a hill above the River Darro. The 9th century castle and fortress, described by Moorish poets as a pearl set in emeralds, in Andalusia. Granada is one of the most charming cities in Spain. Thousands of tourists come to it every year to get to know it through the streets of its traditional neighborhoods. The main enclaves and monuments create a fascinating halo which captivates anyone who comes to visit it.
El Retiro.
Covering over 125 hectares and comprising more than 15,000 trees, El Retiro Park is a green oasis in the heart of the city. In it you'll find all kinds of interesting monuments and gardens. A firm favorite with both locals and tourists, El Retiro is a great place to go rollerblading, for a long walk or a jog.
Guggenheim Museum.
Turned into the symbol of the new Bilbao, Guggenheim Bilbao Museum presents one of the most ambitious cultural projects of the century. The permanent collection includes basically works of art of the most prominent artists of the second half of the 20th century. The Guggenheim Bilbao boasts its own, singular collection, and also complements the other Guggenheim institutions' collections throughout the world.
Real Alcázar.
Strolling through the Alcázar Gardens can be one of the most unforgettable experiences of your visit. They are arranged in terraces, with green vegetation, a multitude of orange and palm trees, with fountains and pavilions where you can breathe the freshness and stillness, a place for calm and rest in the hot city.
Mallorca's beaches.
Mallorca is one of Spain's Balearic islands in the Mediterranean. It's known for beach resorts, sheltered coves, limestone mountains and Roman and Moorish remains. Capital Palma has nightlife, the Moorish Almudena Royal Palace and 13th century Santa Maria Cathedral. Stone-built villages include Pollença, with its art galleries and music festival, and hillside Fornalux, surrounded by citrus plantations.
On top one, finally, France.
Attracting over 89 million tourists each year, France is the world's most visited country. Paris, France's capital city, draws in around 17 million tourists a year, 7 million of those visit the Eiffel Tower. Tourism in France represents 9.7% of the overall GDP and provides 2.9 million jobs. The majority of France's visitors come from other European countries, with over 12 million coming from the United Kingdom. Patched up with idyllic villages and romantic cities, France wears its culture in both iconic landmarks and ordinary settings. Few have the audacity to gild everything in gold, but the country's noble castles, villas and cathedrals pull off ostentatious decor with a nonchalance attributed to its long centuries of royal history. In the list of famous attractions of France, one should must visit the following places.
Eiffel Tower.
Eiffel Tower, undoubtedly, is the first thing you should see while you are in Paris. This magnificent tower was built by Gustave Eiffel to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the French Revolution. Being the symbol of France, this cloud-piercing attraction is the most visited one in the country with about 7 million people every year. At the first tower was meant to stand for 20 years, but you can still see this marvelous masterpiece from every part of Paris.
In fact, it is impossible to imagine Paris without the Eiffel Tower nowadays.
Palace of Versailles.
Planning a trip to Paris anytime soon? If so, then definitely plan on adding a day trip to the Palace of Versailles on your itinerary. It will be more than worth your time. Versailles is the most extravagant example of French Baroque architecture you can find. It drips with gold and exudes glamour. Even after 300 plus years, it serves as stunning design inspiration to creators all over the world.
French Riviera.
French Riviera portraits a beautiful coastline to the south of France, along lies the turquoise blue Mediterranean Sea. French call it Côte d'Azur or the Coast of Azure, where azure means blue. The French Riviera stretches as far as 550 miles and exhibits world's most beautiful beach fronts.
Chamonix.
Fans of sports, snow, and the outdoors love Chamonix for the famous resort at the base of Mont Blanc in the French Alps, home to the first Winter Olympic Games in 1924. From snow sports, to natural beauty, to year-round mountaineering, to the nightlife in Chamonix, this is a place that gets under your skin and never lets you go.
Mont St. Michel.
Mont Saint-Michel is a tiny little commune, on an island in France, and is one of the prettiest places to visit in France. Around its base are medieval walls and towers, above which rise the clustered buildings of the village, with the ancient abbey crowning the mount. One of the more popular tourist attractions in France, Mont Saint-Michel was designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1979.
Paris Bridges. Paris has all the sumptuous architectural details you'd expect from a place boasting centuries of history, and it's a city seemingly designed for taking in fantastic views. No surprise, then, that the French capital harbors some stunning bridges and pedestrian-only footbridges. Paris has 37 bridges. Where the Seine River bisects Paris, are no less than 37 bridges linking the heritage-listed banks. Of these number, 5 are solely pedestrian and 2 are rail bridges.
Thank you guys, for watching this video.
We hope you like this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below in comment box.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel, and press the bell icon.
Take care of yourselves, friends and family members. Bye for now.
Adios amigos.
Top 10 Future Skyscrapers in the World. Hello friends, welcome to Just Top 10. Since the beginning of history, humans have tried to reach the skies. Living in big houses was associated with being at the top of the social hierarchy. If you look up before at one of those iconic, landmark tower structures, you understand how amazing they can be. The craze for tall towers started from Petronas Towers in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, during the latter 90s, and continues to this day. This list of future tallest buildings ranks the tallest buildings in the world which are proposed, approved or under construction. Let's start our video. On number 10, we have Ulaman World Capital Center. The World Capital Center is a proposed skyscraper to be constructed in Colombo, Sri Lanka. With 117 floors and a planned height of 2,051 feet, with the presence of the Board of Investment of Sri Lanka, Chairman Upal Jayasuriya, WCC Chairman Ahmed Maulana, and other officials. However, the BOI clarified that the project approval was granted in principle, and that the investor failed to show a credible track record, and failed to show $200 million in funding before the end of December 2017. Thus, the agreement was cancelled. On number 9, Changchun World Trade Center. The China World Trade Center is located in Chaoyang District, the central business district of Beijing. The construction of the complex started in 1985 and was completed in 2010. The China World Trade Center is the largest building complex of Beijing, consisting of around 14 components, including hotels, all of Shangri-La, shopping malls, offices, apartments, convention rooms, and an exhibition hall. It can be located in the Beijing Central Business District in Guomao. China World Trade Center is well known for being the largest upmarket commercial mixed-use site in the world, and for keeping its reputation as an internationally friendly community. On number 8, Signature Tower, Jakarta. Signature Tower is a proposed skyscraper in Jakarta, Indonesia. The proposed height is 2,093 feet. It was originally proposed in 2010 and was slated to begin construction in 2015. Planning permission for the tower was granted in late 2015. Construction was scheduled to begin in the third quarter of 2016, assuming a loan of approximately $1.5 billion could be successfully secured. China State Construction Engineering has been appointed to construct the tower. The tower is expected to be completed by 2022. The skyscraper is a part of a 45-hectare redevelopment project near the Semanggi Interchange and is just south of the Gelora Bung Karno Stadium. On number 7, H700 Shenzhen Tower. Plans have been submitted for China's tallest skyscraper, the 2,425-feet H700 Shenzhen Tower. Anchoring the gateway to Shenzhen's central business district, the scheme also includes a public plaza that provides retail, civic, and institutional programs. This tower is designed by Chicago-based company BKL Architecture. On number 6, we have Merdeka 118. Merdeka 118 is a 118-story, 2,113-feet megatall skyscraper, currently under construction in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It is the tallest building under construction as of September 2020. Upon completion, the structure will become the tallest building in Malaysia and Southeast Asia, and the second tallest building in the world. When completed in 2021, the tower will be the tallest building in Malaysia. It will consist of 4,300,000 square feet of residential, hotel, and commercial space. On number 5, we have Tower M. Tower M, formerly called the KLCC Eastgate Tower, is a proposed megatall skyscraper project in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, located at Kuala Lumpur City Center, KLCC. The new building could comprise three office towers on top of a retail podium and come up on 4 acres of land named Lots L, L1 and M, next to the Mass Rapid Transit, MRT, KLCC East Station. It is planned to be 2,297 feet high and have 145 stories. In July 2018, KLCCH, the landowner, stated that there are no immediate plans to construct the office towers. If the demand arises, planning is unlikely to start before the year 2030. On number 4, Shimao, Shenzhen Hong Kong International Center. Construction is underway on the Shimao Shenzhen Hong Kong International Center, a 668-meter high megatall skyscraper in Shenzhen, China. Details of the design are sparse and the architect is unknown, but the Shenzhen Tower is the project of Chinese property developers the Xiamo Group, which has reportedly invested 50 billion yuan in the project. Located in the Longgang district in the eastern part of Shenzhen, the center is expected to have a floor plan of 321,900 square meters. On number 3, Dubai One Tower. The Dubai One Tower is a proposed megatall residential building in Dubai, United Arab Emirates. At 2,333 feet, it would be the tallest residential building in the world and the fourth tallest building in the world when completed. It will feature 885 residential apartments and a five-star hotel with 350 rooms. As of March 2017, this tower is still intended to be built, with Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum laying the groundwork for construction of the associated mall. It is expected to be completed in 2023. On number 2, Burj Mubarak Al Kabir. The Burj Mubarak Al Kabir is a proposed mega tall skyscraper in Kuwait City, Kuwait. It will be part of the future city called Madinat Al Hair. Expected completion is likely to be around in 2030. If built, it would become the world's tallest building, surpassing the Burj Khalifa in Dubai. Its height is in order to reflect the folktale collection 1001 Arabian Nights. If built, the tower would be the tallest skyscraper in Kuwait, surpassing Al Hamra Tower. Skyscrapers do not normally exceed 80 floors due to the amount of space that would be taken up by elevators. However, the Mubarak Al Kabir Tower would consist of a far greater number of floors. This would necessitate double or triple-decker elevators. On top 1, Jeddah Tower. At the forefront of worldwide skyscraper activity, Jeddah Tower represents an unprecedented exercise that dares to go beyond the 1 km threshold, a hype that seemed only to exist in fantasy just years ago. Inspired by a bundle of leaves shooting up from the ground, it is meant to emanate the growth, prosperity, and regional emergence of its homeland on the global stage, a role that many of the world's tallest buildings have played in their respective locales. The multivariate form of the tower is rationalized by a wire-shaped plan and a continuously smooth taper, which will significantly reduce structural loads by obviating the need for the complicated outrigger transfers and belt trusses required in a setback approach. Furthermore, each wing of the tower will terminate at different heights, allowing them to taper at different rates and establish a distinct three-part spire.
Thank you guys for watching this video.
We hope you liked this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below in comment box.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon.
Take care of yourselves, friends and family members. Bye for now.
Adios amigos.
Top 10 serial killers in the world's history. A serial killer is typically a person who murders three or more people in two or more separate events over a period of time for primarily psychological reasons. This list shows serial killers from the 20th century to present day by number of victims. In many cases, the exact number of victims assigned to a serial killer is not known, and even if that person is convicted of a few, there can be the possibility that they killed many more. This list is a compilation of modern serial killers currently with the highest verifiable murder count.
Killer number 10, Anatoly Onoprienko.
Anatoly Yuryovich Onoprienko, born July 25, 1959, was a Soviet-Ukrainian serial mass murderer. He was also known by the nicknames the Beast of Ukraine, the Terminator, and Citizen O. After police arrested the 36-year-old former forestry student on April 16, 1996, Onoprienko confessed to killing 52 people.
Killer number 9, Andrei Chikatilo.
Andrei Romanovich Chikatilo was a Soviet serial killer nicknamed the Butcher of Rostov, the Red Ripper, and the Rostov Ripper, who sexually assaulted, murdered, and mutilated at least 52 women and children between 1978 and 1990 in the Russian, the Ukrainian, and the Uzbek.
Chikatilo confessed to 56 murders and was tried for 53 of these killings in April 1992.
He was convicted and sentenced to death for 52 of these murders in October 1992, although the Supreme Court of Russia ruled in 1993 that insufficient evidence existed to prove Chikatilo's guilt in 9 of these murders.
Chikatilo was subsequently executed in February 1994. Killer number 8, Yang Shinhai.
Yang Shinhai, born July 29, 1968, also known as Yang Dia and Yang Lu, was a Chinese serial killer who confessed to committing 67 murders and 23 rapes between 1999 and 2003, and was sentenced to death and executed for 67. He was dubbed the Monster Killer by the media. He is the most prolific known serial killer China has seen since the establishment of the People's Republic of China in 1949.
Killer number 7, Kampadimar Shankaria.
He was born in Jaipur, Rajasthan in 1952 and arrested at the age of 26. He confessed that he had killed at least 70 people in 1977 to 1978 for pleasure. He killed his victims by hitting them with a hammer on the neck below the ears, which gained him the moniker Kampadimar, one who hits under ear.
He was convicted in early 1979 and was hanged at Jaipur on May 16, 1979.
He repented, and his last words before being hanged were, "I have murdered in vain.
Nobody should become like me." Killer number 6, Pedro Rodriguez Filho.
Pedro Rodriguez Filho, born July 17, 1954, also known as Pedrinho Matador, Killer Petey, is a Brazilian serial killer who pursued and killed other criminals. His victims included 47 people who were murdered inside the prisons in which he was imprisoned. Rodriguez was born on a farm in Santa Rita do Sabucai, south of Minas Gerais, with his skull bruised as a result of his father kicking his pregnant mother's belly during a fight. He claimed he wanted to kill for the first time at age 13 in a fight with an older cousin. He pushed the young man into a sugarcane press, almost killing him.
Killer number 5, Daniel Camargo Barbosa. Daniel Camargo Barbosa, born January 22, 1930, was a Colombian serial killer. It is believed that he raped and murdered up to 150 young girls in Colombia and Ecuador during the 1970s and 1980s. Camargo's mother died before he had even reached the age of one, and his father was overbearing and emotionally distant. Afterwards, his father married another woman who had infertility problems. This caused his new stepmother to become abusive to Daniel, humiliating him in various ways. One of which, she dressed him up as a girl and forced him to go to school dressed that way, to where his peers and classmates made fun of him.
Killer number 4, Mikhail Popkov.
Mikhail Viktorovich Popkov, born March 7, 1964, is a Russian serial killer and rapist who sexually assaulted and murdered 78 women between 1992 and 2010 in Angarsk, Irkutsk, and Vladivostok in Siberia. He is known as the werewolf and the Angarsk maniac for the brutal nature of his crimes. One of Russia's most prolific serial killers, Popkov was convicted of 22 murders in 2015 and confessed to 59 additional homicides 3 years later. On December 10, 2018, he was convicted for 56 of the 59 additional homicides. For three killings, the police could not find proof. Popkov received a second life sentence. There were calls for Popkov to be executed, but this was unavailable as capital punishment is not allowed in Russia.
Killer number 3, Javed Iqbal.
Javed Iqbal Amer was a Pakistani serial killer who confessed to the sexual abuse and murder of 100 boys, ranging in age from 6 to 16. Iqbal strangled the victims, dismembered the corpses, and dissolved them in acid as a way to conceal the evidence. He was found guilty and sentenced to death in the same manner that he killed the boys, being strangled first, then cut into 100 pieces in front of the parents of the victims, and then be dissolved into acid, but he committed suicide before the sentence could be carried out.
Killer number 2, Pedro Lopez.
Pedro Alonso Lopez, born October 8, 1948, is a Colombian serial killer who was sentenced for killing 110 girls, but who claimed to have raped and killed more than 300 girls across Colombia, Peru, and Ecuador. Aside from unsighted local accounts, Lopez's crimes first received international attention from an interview conducted by Ron Leitner, a longtime freelance photojournalist who reported interviewing Lopez in his Ambato prison cell in 1980. Leitner's interviews were widely published, first in the Chicago Tribune on Sunday, July 13, 1980, and in the Toronto Sun and the Sacramento Bee on July 21, 1980, and over the years in many other North American papers and foreign publications, including the National Enquirer. Apart from Leitner's account and two brief Associated Press wire reports, the story was published in the world's most infamous murders by Bohr and Blundell, and has found its way into many serial murder anthologies, both in print and online.
Killer number 1, Luis Garavito.
Luis Alfredo Garavito Cubillos, born January 25, 1957, also known as La Bestia, the Beast, is a Colombian rapist and serial killer. In 1999, he admitted to the rape, torture, and murder of 138 boys and teenagers. His victims, based on the locations of skeletons listed on maps that Garavito drew in prison, could exceed 300. Garavito continues to confess to more murders. He has been described by local media as the world's worst serial killer. The judicial body ruled that all Garavito sentences total 1,853 years and 9 days in jail.
Thank you guys for watching this video.
We hope you liked this video. If you want to suggest us any topic, please comment below in comment box.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon.
Take care of yourselves, friends and family members. Bye for now.
Adios amigos.